What's up, guys? It's your boy Swills here. The lighting's a bit bad. I understand the lighting is pretty bad. Maybe I'll turn around, you get a little bit better lighting. Today, I'm going to be taking a quick look as a review of the Anthony Joshua Kubrat Pulev championship heavyweight fight. It just finished, and let me tell you, it was a pretty good fight. Kubrat Pulev is very well known to be a scrappy fighter, so his fights typically are pretty entertaining. With Anthony Joshua, he's always a knockout boxer, besides Andy Ruiz, of course, where he got knocked out and then, you know, as a result decided to fight the long fight to regain his belts in the rematch. And he kind of looked like he was going to go that direction again. It looked like, you know, perhaps Andy Ruiz kind of changed his career path to where he was going to start becoming a bit more like a Floyd Mayweather type, where he was just going to counterpunch, sit back, throw his jabs, and just get through the fights and win them like that. Because he's very capable of doing that. He's a big guy. He's got very lengthy. He's got long arms. He can do that if he wants to. And I thought for the first couple rounds, that's what it was going to look like. And then the third round came. Knocked down Pulev twice. It looked like Pulev was ready to go out. Luckily for him, the round ended, and it almost worked against Anthony Joshua. And I started, as the fight continued to go, I started to get more and more nervous for Anthony Joshua because Pulev was just pounding him a little bit, especially, you know, round 7, 8, and as we got a little bit deeper into the fight, Pulev was kind of having this fight or flight. He decided to fight, and he was not quitting, and he was really getting on the inside. And I was worried for Joshua, because Joshua, he was trying to do that dirty fight too. He was getting on the inside, trying to fight Pulev the way Pulev wanted him to. And I started to get worried that Joshua was getting a bit too confident, and he was getting a bit too arrogant, and he was really looking to put him away without any real reason to. And so I think tactically he kind of threw it away a little bit in the mid rounds, and then later Anthony Joshua, luckily for him, or not luckily, it's skill, for Anthony Joshua, he finished the fight. Great uppercuts. That's going to be the story of this fight. Joshua had some crazy uppercut combos. He was throwing them in groups of 3, 4, 5, and that's what put Pulev out of this fight. The uppercuts were insane. For Joshua, it's a great fight to welcome him to Tyson Fury. Hopefully that's the next fight, is a unification between Anthony Joshua and Tyson Fury. Otherwise, you know, what's next? Usyk, Alexander Usyk, maybe even, crazy enough, Deontay Wilder. Who knows? But it's a bit early to think about that. I didn't see the press conferences or the interviews inside the ring. Instead, I'm recording this video. So perhaps they've already talked about that in the ring. I don't know. Let me know in the comments if that's the case. But for Pulev, you know, I'm impressed by his spirit. He was throwing quite a bit of punches behind the head when they were in the clinch. I was a bit disappointed to see that. He was fighting a little dirty. I didn't like that at all. But he had some great punches. If he would have had a little bit more athleticism, a little bit more technique to those hooks, perhaps he really could have done some damage to Joshua, because Joshua left himself quite open in the mid rounds. So, you know, unlucky for him. He's got to, you know, maybe that's it for him. I don't know. Maybe he retires in the ring. I'm not paying attention to the post-fight ring interviews. So maybe he did, maybe he didn't. I don't know. But I don't really know what's next for Pulev. I think he's going to be in a tough spot. He's not going to get another shot like this in his career. That's for sure. But let me know what you think about the fight in the comments section down below. Leave a like, subscribe if you're new. You know, hopefully this gets out to a bunch of the Brits. I have a primary American audience. If there's some Brits watching this, please like and subscribe. Because I do like doing boxing. I like doing MMA. I like doing all of it. And yeah, and I'll see you guys in the next video. Peace out.